The next set of instruments to be analyzed are iron, manganese, chloride, nitrate, etc. For analysis of these samples, we use a method called colorimetry. Colorimetry is nothing but development of color and afterwards measurement of color. Development and measurement of color together is called colorimetry. Colorimetry is a very, very widely used method for all types of analysis, especially in health. In analysis of urine, blood, everywhere, this is it. The basic principle is that, for example, we want to see the presence of iron. What we do is, we add a chemical to that water, so that there is a reaction between iron and that chemical. And because of that reaction, a color is formed. And the intensity of that color is proportional to the quantity of iron present in it. This is a simple example only. And this is the same method, the same procedure is used for many, many other chemicals. The typical example, the measurement of color intensity is done. You can just imagine that this is a test tube where there is the colored water is filled. And the principle is, we are allowing light to go through it. When light is going, some light will be transmitted. Some light will be absorbed. Some light will be refracted. And the light refracted is really negligible. So we consider either the absorbed light or the transmitted light. This is the basic principle of colorimetry. There are many, many instruments, you know, instruments which are capable of measuring the light intensity. They are called spectrophotometer. Spectrophotometer, and even colorimeter is there. While using this method, we have to be very cautious that there is a specified wavelength for everything. For every chemical, for iron, manganese, for every chemical, there is a prescribed chemical to be added and also the wavelength. And the chart gives you a small description of what are things. First one is for iron. The chemical to be added for developing color is 110 pinometer. And the color will be approximately red and the wavelength to be used is 510. Similarly for manganese, ammonium persulfate is added. The color developed will be pink. And the wavelength to be used is 525. And for fluoride, sparse reagent is used and the wavelength is 570. Normally there will not be any apparent color, but the instrument measures the color. And especially for nitrate, one normality HCl is added. The wavelength is 220 to 270. There will not be apparent color will not be there. But there will be difference in the colorimetric reading. We can measure either absorbance or transmittance, and from that we will be able to calibrate the instrument. And we will show you how we analyze iron, and from that you will be able to understand what is meant by colorimetry. Colorimetry, the fundamentals of colorimetry is only this much. And this is a very, very widely used method, not only in our environmental engineering, but in all the fields of measurement like health, everywhere it is used. And this is a very basic fundamental. Now we will be showing you how to analyze iron by using this method. Thank you.